Okay, another question. How about right here? I always like to prefer the young ones.
Nathan, you believe in Noah's Ark, right?
Yeah, I do.
So God told Noah to get all the animals and put it on the ark, right?
No, not all of them.
Okay.
Like all the aquatic animals, they just had to swim their way around.
Okay. So then it says in the Bible that the flood went over the highest mountains in the world, and that includes Mount Everest, right?
No.
Well, I don't know about that.
Okay, but even if it did, then the animals could not breathe because there's no oxygen up there.
Yeah, you know, you're Bernie's boy, right? Yeah, okay. So, so like your dad can tell you about how those mountains were formed. The question is, when were they formed? So, you know, you have tectonic plates. Have you ever been to the Steins here in southeastern Oregon?
I don't think so.
Make sure your dad takes you there. Because you see this big plate just come right up out of the flatness of the earth. It just goes bam like that. And then there's these huge, jutting, high elevation peaks and these caverns, canyons. It's beautiful. Everest came out. Everest is relatively young for dates. And you know, you and I could get into all the dating and how old the earth is and all that. But Everest is young because it's jagged and tall. That's about what I know.
Okay, but it took longer than 2,000 years to form.
Well, I agree with you on that. Not everyone in the room who's a Christian will agree with you on that. Yeah, but I do think that it's probably longer than 2,000 years.
Can I have a quick comment?
Sure.
Okay. You can have a comment at home, too.
Yeah. The Bible literally says that the highest mountain was covered, by over 100 feet. Why is that? Well, because if it wasn't, the animals wouldn't have been killed. God's design was to kill the animals. It says in there it was to kill all the land breathers, all the air breathers. So anything that had the breath of air in its lungs was going to get destroyed. Sometimes young earth creationists think, oh, well, you know, yeah, those mountains were created just really quick, boom. They weren't that high back then. Like you said, you know, there's no oxygen up there that was that covered up that high. So sometimes they say, well, maybe the mountains just, after the flood, the mountains just did that real quick. But when you understand the plate tectonics, I mean, if the earth moves by just a tiny amount, you have massive earthquakes. And so here you're saying, forget about that, just magnified by a billion, that's what happens. You know, all these land masses move and everything in a matter of months, you know. So it's a huge conflict with modern science. Now again, the evolutionary creationists, they'll say, hey, we have no problem with it, but we accept science 100%. Of course Noah's Ark is a myth. It's not there to teach you science or even be a historical story. It's there to teach you a theological truth. It's a story that teaches something about sin and all that. So if you're that kind of a Christian, there's no conflict with science. But if you're a young earther or old earther, and you believe in a worldwide flood, I mean, even a local flood, the old birders say there's a local flood, just a local area. That doesn't make sense either. There's no sense in saving birds that could easily fly a shelter. You know, so I mean, there's all these problems with science.
Okay, right here, Mr. Southridge.
Okay, so Pastor Lewis, you stated that you literally believe in Noah's Ark, right?
Yeah.
So Noah's Ark landed on one mountain.
I believe that's the way the story goes.
And all the animals came out. And so what we would expect from that story is that all the animals would be distributed across the world evenly from that point. Okay? But we have mountains, we have monkeys, I'm sorry, that we only find in Madagascar. They're in no other place in the entire world. So all of them got off the ark, hiked down to Africa, jumped over 500 miles of water, and landed in Madagascar instead of spreading evenly across the world.
Yeah, I don't think you'll find anything in the biblical text that tells you that all the animals left Noah's Ark and spread out like that. You're assuming that from the text. What we don't know is what else happened to develop all these different species. What we do know is that different species, there's more than we know of even today. don't know all of their historic genetic trail. Yeah, but you know, to tell you the truth, I haven't thought that much about it because my read of that text is, and this is how nearly all ancient literature is. It's from the perspective of the main character in the story. So Noah is on the ark, and what does he see? It's described for you there, what he saw. Noah wasn't a scientist telling you all of this information from a laboratory or from a genus chart. But this is what I saw from the deck of the boat. And if you read it that way, it's quite plausible. And your brother's got a question.
Yes, I do.
Go ahead.
Earlier, I just want to confirm that you said that you believe for a fact that Adam and Eve started the human race. Is that true?
Well, I believe that God started the human race. That with he Adam. Created, yeah, that he created first Adam, and then he created Eve.
From, okay.
Yeah.
So,